Welcome back to Mailbag Monday. Today we're starting with Don't Stand So Close to Me Dark Amber Ale from Devil May Care Brewing. In September of 1980, the Police released a song. It has nothing to do with viruses, pandemics, or social distancing, but 40 years later, that lyric suddenly is far too relevant. Well, this whole pile of mail over here needs opening, I guess. What should I start with? Let's start with that one. So first thing in today says test lead. Let's not cut through it, shall we? We'll cut the bag anyways. More plastic and more plastic. Ah, okay. So, this is just a pair of banana to clip leads. Those feel fairly flexible. They feel more flexible than these ones, although they look almost identical. Let's just see how they compare. Where's my lowest ohm setting? So the existing ones that I've got are 2. Let's just give it the best chance. 1.8 ohms. Somewhere between 1.8 and 2 point something. Let's try this brand new pair. Not that I needed another cheap set, but it's just sometimes convenient to have. Those are better. Half an ohm? That's reasonable. Okay. Is that repeatable? Sure. Admittedly, that's not the most accurate meter in the world, although it's pretty damn good in my tests against better meters. So, okay, I guess these are going to be my go-to cheap clip lead for meters. Nice. Testwire Probe Leads Silicone Banana Plug to Crocodile Alligator Clips, 102 centimeters. One piece for $1.79 Canadian, which is what I paid. Currently $2.29 shipping. There wasn't any back when I bought these back in March. Took 48 days to get here. Yeah, not too horrible, I guess. I got these from Good Jewelry 8. Fully insulated, sharper probe tips. No, it doesn't have probe tips. 4mm banana plugs. Yeah, small size alligators. Sure, portable and convenient. Red, black, whatever, whatever. And they claim these are silicone wire. I'm not sure about that. They do feel more flexible than the other ones, though, and they're definitely better electrically, so we'll go with it. That's not bad. Decent malt, a little hoppier than I normally like, but I like it anyway. 3.5mm, 6.35mm, and then a bunch of Chinese language. Who knows what that is? Well, I'm sure somebody does, but it is. Oh, a couple more of these kind of adapter things. Okay. So that one is 3.5mm to screw terminals. You've seen these things. You've seen these before. I've bought a few of those already. They're just handy for testing things. And then there's this one, which is the 1/4". Okay. Down to the same thing. And oh, this one is using one of these kind of connectors, which are really nice. I think I've actually got a few of those kicking around too. And the mating connector that just goes into a circuit board. But that's really convenient when you need to be able to plug onto a circuit board and disconnect just to remove the thing for maintenance or whatever. But this one is to a 1/4" stereo or balanced depending on your application. Three connections anyways. 3.5mm 3-Plo stereo male plug to AV screw video Bowen. I'm not going to rant on about that because I've done that before. Terminal jack connector. $1.49 American or $1.97 Canadian. I paid $1.31 for it back in January. From Passion to a 1314. And the 1/4" version, a one piece adapter, 6.35mm, 1/4" male plug to AV screw terminal, plug stereo for video. Hey, they're not lying about it being a Balun, which it isn't. Currently going for $3.16 Canadian. I bought it for $2.10 Canadian back in January. There was free shipping on it then, and neither of these are shipping to Canada at the moment. Because
because reasons. This package took 107 days to get here. I guess that was peak Corona time in China and before it kind of hit North America. So that's understandable.
Okay, next in, adapter. That's what the last ones were, but this must be a different kind of adapter. Oh. This is a whole bunch of coaxial power adapters from the standard, was it 5-point-something millimeter that most of our Arduino-ish things use, most of the power system, or hang on, yeah, 5.2 millimeter. So these ones that we commonly use in Arduino world these days, that is the connector on the back of there. And so we have 8 different sizes, including this one with the male center pin in it, which some laptops use. Okay, that's going to come in really handy. Are these labeled? Just letter labels, A through H. Okay, maybe the listing says what the actual sizes are.
8-in-1 universal PC notebook laptop AC-DC power charger adapter tips connector Q. I got this from Queens 888. They're currently, well, no, they don't actually have any in stock right now. I paid $2.74 for these back in March. All right, so on the male side of these connectors, I guess that's the male side, we vary from 3.5 to 1.35 millimeters on this one. So 3.5 on the outside, 1.35 on the inside, all the way up to 6.5 by 4.4 and a variety in between. That's actually useful to know what these might fit into. Those are definitely going to be handy. So since this seller doesn't have any available at the moment, I am going to link you to this search, which will come up with a whole bunch of them from various different sellers at various different price points.
All right, let's get the rattly one in here. It says terminals on there. That makes sense with the noises it's making. Maybe some kind of connectors or, an assortment of insulated crimp terminals. I got a bunch of uninsulated ones in a previous mailbag. So these are generally considered automotive, but they're also good for any kind of low voltage DC wiring. They are just different kinds of crimp-on-wire terminals. I'm probably going to get this wrong, but I think... Oh, no, never mind. I don't have to guess. It says on there. The ones with the red sleeve on them are good for 22-gauge up to 16-gauge. The ones with the blue... Oh, those are interesting. Where is it? Yeah, the blue ones are good for 16 to 14-gauge wiring. I think the yellow ones are good for up to 12 gauge. Where's something that'll tell me? 12 to 10 gauge, it says. Yeah, so that covers a good variety of wire gauges. And we have different types of terminals as well. We have these little narrow guys. We have the more standard spades in both male and female. And we have the fork terminals. Oh, those are pretty wimpy. There's not a lot of meat there. Those ones are a little bit better, but they're still pretty skinny. However, those do still have an application, even though they're kind of tiny and don't inspire confidence. Some types of screw terminal blocks, not this one, but some that we have at work, actually, the barriers are much narrower together, and you can't actually get a wider one with more meat on it in there. So that actually does have an application, having those skinny ones. Now, again, you wouldn't want to draw huge amounts of current through that because there's not that much meat there. But in certain applications, it's a good choice.
280 pieces, assorted crimp spade terminal, insulated electrical wire connector kit set. Got these from Depon 20, something like that. Currently selling them for $11.21 Canadian. Back in February when I bought these, they were $6.98. So here's the kit. It's pretty much what I... Oh, ring terminals. I didn't notice those before. Just in the red. Okay. 20 pieces, 2.8 millimeter female red, 22 to 16, yeah. 2.8 millimeter male, 4.8 millimeter male and female, 6.3 millimeter female, 6.3 millimeter male. Okay, all in the red. Red fork terminal and red ring terminal. And then 4.8 millimeter, 6.3 millimeter male and female in the blue, which is 16 to 14 gauge. And blue forks and 19 amp. That's a little aggressive. How come that's the only one that rates amperage on it? I still think that's a little aggressive. And then 10 pieces, 6.3 millimeter male and female of the yellow for 12 to 10 gauge. So not a lot that we didn't already know, except for the widths of those spades.
And the last thing in this cardboardy box, it says module. That's why I saved it for last, because modules are always the most fun, aren't they? Aren't they? If it is, in fact, a module. Ooh, a soldering iron tip. Ah, and a soldering iron handle. Oh, this is for the T12, isn't it? Yeah, I think it is. You remember the T12 iron and controller that I was generously gifted by one of my viewers?
Okay, watch address in the channel description for your convenience.
So, this iron tip here that I chose with it, I think I chose it, maybe it just came with it. It is a conical tip. Most of the ones that I prefer are this shape here. That one's good for through hole. I've been using this one for smaller stuff and surface mount. And then there's this new one that's conical, which several people have suggested that I get because everybody's got their own preference and apparently my choice is wrong. So, and the other thing in here is a different handle. There's nothing wrong with this handle. This claims to be an actual Heiko FX handle. And that slides right in there. Okay. That's good. But I just noticed that connector doesn't match up with this. At least I don't think it does. No, it doesn't. You're at bastards. So I still can't use this. And the reason that one of the reasons why I got this new handle, not that there's anything wrong with the other one, is that it's the one that's designed to fit in that stand. That's the only reason for the stand holding. But it turns out I've got the wrong connector on this end. I don't want to chop the handle off, the connector off this one, because I like the feel of it, and I just don't want to get into that game. I guess back to eBay to buy another connector to put onto this one. Well, that's a little disappointing. I was hoping to be able to fire it up.
Replace FX9501 soldering handle plus T12 tips for Heiko F951 soldering station. I got this from Sam Love. I paid $16.80 back in March. However, for some reason, the listing was ended because there was an error in it, and I don't understand exactly what it was. But if I look closely at this picture, it does show the connector that I got. So that's my bad. This guy up here looks like it's got the connector that I should have ordered. And they want $32 for it. Anyway, what does it say on here? 70 watts, 24 volts, 2 ohms between the tip and earth.
1.2 meter cord, 30 grams, yeah. And it comes with one tip and one iron handle. Well, I'm disappointed in my lack of attention. I think I was just chasing the lowest price and I didn't look carefully. Damn it. I guess the lesson here is pay really close attention to what you're getting, what you're ordering. Just like I didn't. There's the connector that I really wanted on it. GX12-6. 6-pin female. And I did a few measurements and it seems to match with this data sheet that I found. And there is all the information about it, should you care about this connector type. 5 amps, 250 volts. Wow.
Well, even when everything doesn't go perfectly, it's still a fun mailbag to do. So, I think I went through some of the time shipping times, but I'll just quickly run through them anyways. This banana clip cable took 48 days. These two adapters took 107 days. These adapters took 51 days. The crimp terminals took 97. And this thing, which I made a mistake ordering, took 66 days. But I will order another connector for this and I'll figure out the pinout and we'll make it work. So, thank you once again for watching. I do appreciate it. Thanks, as always, to my Patreon supporters who help me finance this madness and buy me a beer now and again. That's just so groovy of those people over there. What else to say? Yeah, not much. Comments, questions down below as usual. Thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.